The 10th edition of the Route du Rhum is well underway now, with most of the 91-strong fleet having spent three full days at sea. In this single-handed yacht race, all navigational systems are authorized, including routing systems to help with the journey between St Malo and Pointe Pitre. A routing system is the boat's own meteorological consulting and tracking system, which is based on land and helps the skippers with strategical choices, notably to help them try and beat the race record of 7 days, 17 hours and 19 minutes. We have the equivalent of an instant messaging software that we have on iPads, iPhones, actually all tablets. It will wake you up with an alarm. I'm not overly fond of these routing systems, but it is necessary because sooner or later skippers will lose some lucidity. Skippers will have trouble in recovering from constant maneuvers, which with these boats are extremely demanding physically, especially at my age. These are computer systems that for years, even decades now, are based on statistics, weather forecasts. These are extremely complex systems that calculate weather routing. Strangely, it makes me feel old because it can get very stressful. It's demanding, but it's an amazing thing because for those who are really into these things, you can get control of the situation. After just 3 days of sailing, 16 of the record 91 starters have abandoned, 2004 Vendée Globe winner Vincent Rieu being the latest. Currently leading the race to Guadeloupe is Peyron, who had a 60-plus nautical mile advantage as he passed west of Madeira on Tuesday night.